All right, so yesterday, one of your friends asked me, can we actually do a nested jump? Okay, so nested means something like the ones we see in subroutine. Okay, so this is an example of I have two, it's quite small here. Just going to clear a bit. So I have jump number one and then jump number two. So basically, if I jump number one, I will execute. I will not execute everything in between, and only execute this line and this line. Okay. If I jump number two, that means I'll be executing lem number one. And timer, right? The CR1. Okay, CR1 is not gonna work because we jumped the second one. And also lem 3 and 2. Okay, so if we run everything, then of course you will have every line working except number 8, rung number 8. Okay, so okay, rung number 8 is not working because we have CR1 normally closed here, so obviously it's gonna break straight away when this CR1 is activated. Okay, so the way we put jump like this means like it will work in the same way as interlock. It's just like the difference between interlock and jump is that the jump itself will not disable the output. Okay, so for example, if we decided that we're going to make the jump, okay, so I'm going to set on. And we can see that the output in between is not working at all, alright? Unless lamp 3, obviously, because CR1 is off, so we will have normally closed connection there. So you can see that everything else is not working at this point, right? So if I suddenly wanted to make the jump here, alright? The jump here, so I will turn on this, okay? And you can see that. The jump itself cannot be done simply because the workaround that I said just now. Okay, you cannot simply wanted to make the jump when you origin when we when you have originally run everything already in full instructions without the jumping. So I'm gonna reset first the rest of the program. Okay. So if you wanted to jump, okay, in between here, so it's just the outside is gonna work. So I can set that one on right now, and we can see that PB this one should be turned off, okay, because we want to jump in between. We will not jump this, okay? The lamp one must be working, okay? So if I turn on or set on, and we can see that only in between jumps are not working, okay? So, well, this is good, especially because if we want the outside to be working, okay, but not the inside. Not the inside, okay? So in this case, we are jumping the middle section if we want to work only on the inside. Okay, so say that okay, so to do that, we have to disable everything first. We want to only the inside to work. Okay, so for that, for this to be able to be done, that means we wanted only this one to work, all right? And this one should not work. Okay, so we're running this. Okay, so the inside one is running. Okay, and the outside one is not running. Okay, so the problem with this is now is that with jump number there, it will obviously will run lamp one. All right, so if we don't want lamp 1 to be executed. Okay, so we will have to put portions on the outside that we don't want to work to be executed, and so both at the top and at the bottom. Okay, so that means we have to put JME 1 here. And and basically have another jump at the top of the timer. So I will just turn PB3 and have, so what is PB3? Sorry, PB3 is 002. Have another jump here, JMP. Number 3. Okay, so now you can see that by having each of the sections that you wanted to be on and off warded off separately, you can make this jump repeatedly. Okay, so for example, if I turn on here, oops, sorry, work online simulator here. So if I wanted to jump lamp 1, so it's gonna set on here, and obviously if I set on PB3, I will jump both at the top and at the bottom. So if I turn this one off and only turn this one on, okay, because we wanted to jump the jump to not happen inside but only happen at the outside. So if I turn this one on, okay, so obviously the lamp 1 is not working, but lamp 4 is working, okay, and the timer is not working as well, okay, so obviously there is no counting down happening. So the idea of like nested jumps, jump inside the jump is possible, but like I've shown you previously, when jump is inside, when there's a jump inside another jump, it will work the same way as interlock. It's just like that the output will not be turned off when the jump is disabled. Okay, but you can actually execute certain instructions in between by disabling or basically section of each of the instructions using different jump numbers. Okay, if you wanted to make sure that some portions is taken off and then some portions is executed. So with this application of jump, you can basically take off any sections of the program and just run whatever left in the program. It's just you have to make sure that all the interdependencies are well taken care of.